Hello and welcome to the video. For this one, it's going to be a few random things about alignments, steering linkages, and one other eventful thing that happened to me this morning that I'll get to at the end. So let's start. Just got done from the alignment shop. So the truck's got a fresh alignment now. It's got a new steering linkage on it, which if we come down and take a look at it, it is the Mopar, OEM style Mopar, just like the one that came off the truck. And it's the T style with this bolt, this inner drag link end that points perpendicular to the ground. And then you have the bracket for your steering shock. That's the difference between T and Y style. A lot of people will upgrade to this because it's a lower risk of death wobble. This is an 09 model, so it came with this style from factory, 08.5 and up. Some 08s had it, some didn't, but all the 09s had it. So this truck had it, and here's the old one. So drag link end, boot was torn. Some sloppiness in that one. Not terrible. This one, same deal with the slop, although probably not quite as much, and reasonable. Like, I don't think that was too bad. The inner tie rod end here had a crack boot. It's looking pretty dry in there, but nothing else out of whack with this one. And then this one is just all seized. It barely moves. Even if you put a lot of force on it, it's kind of stuck. You know, with the brand new one, yes, it took some force to move it. That's good. But it was able to be moved in all directions. This one seems to have somehow gotten seized up. And after the replacement, the steering did tighten up a little bit. It didn't solve all of my steering problems. I asked the guys at the shop to give me their opinion about the steering box, and they say that there is indeed some slop in it, although it's not crazy. It's not like a second gen or anything, but there is some slop there that makes the steering less, you know, it's not ideal. You know, it doesn't steer quite as tight as my other truck does. So if I want to get that to truck to steer that well, I need to do something about the steering box. But this is a good upgrade. It did lead to an improvement. Now, how about alignment? So we have our before and after. It looked like the camber was out of whack a little. I'm not even sure if that's really adjustable on these trucks. Perhaps I'm mistaken. The caster is definitely not adjustable, likely due to the fixed control arms. And we also have non-adjustable ball joints. So the toe is really what I was looking for. And before, it had 0.11 degrees there, 0.08 on that side. After, we got it to 0.11 still here, but 0.10 there. It's a bit more even on the toe. But they still did a toe in. I floated the idea about doing a zero toe. I wasn't adamant about it. I said, you know, whatever y'all think, but I floated the idea because of how the tires are wearing. Let's look at the tires. Just a slightly faster wear on these outside tread blocks versus the inside, which is pretty much not worn at all since the tires were new. And so I'm hoping the new alignment is better than the old. We also had a slight leftward pull of the truck, which we still have even after this alignment, although maybe it is slightly improved. So the most important part was getting the new linkage on and getting a decent alignment done afterwards. But I was hoping that we would get rid of that leftward pull and hopefully improve the tire wear, which we have yet to see. We'll see about it. So that is the alignment. What else do I have? With this stock style linkage, they are non-greasable, so there is no maintenance for it, but you also don't get to grease it. I'm not super opinionated about having greasable tie rod ends like I am with ball joints. I love greasable ball joints. But if you remember to do it, you can't go wrong with the greasable steering linkage. Okay, now for the story of the day. So the other day, about a week ago, I swapped out coolant elbow, the HVAC coolant elbow here. That guy. It's been fine for a week, about 500 miles. And then on the way down here, right after I got out of the lineman shop, I noticed my fan clutch was running. I'm like, why is it running? The AC's not on. The weather's not that hot. So I look down at my temperature gauge. It's like 220. So I pull over and pop the hood. And sure enough, coolant is pouring. As you can see, there's a lot of residue on the exhaust manifold from that. And I dumped about 2 gallons of coolant in 1 mile. So shut the truck off, push this back into place, and, you know, messing around with it, like, it's not like it's just easily lifts off. I mean, I've put a fair amount of force on it, and it won't pull off. So I don't understand it, but I don't trust it now. So I think I'm going to go to AutoZone and see if they'll let me get a new one. Maybe this one's defective in some way, and I'll try that. But yeah, it scares me a bit that popped off. The good news is I had a couple gallons of water, and I have about a half a gallon of straight coolant back there too. If I can just get home, I will have to actually add coolant to the radiator and get some of the water out, because now it's been diluted. So that's what I'm gonna go do now and see what happens there. Might even just bring you all along on that. Fun fact of the day. This steering linkage weighs 40 pounds. About half a gallon, and that should do it. Guess we're doing a little bit of a coolant refresh. I mean, if the fat fitting continues to hold, I'm not gonna worry about ordering too much coolant, but I have in my cart on Amazon the 6 gallon case, because it's the only size I can get, but I can get 6 gallons for $100, which is a very good price on Xerex. Let's go ahead and just top this off. All right, so I've made the decision to just go to AutoZone and get another one and swap it out and see what happens. If this happens again, I'm going to go ahead and try to track down the actual Cummins part number and see if I can get an OEM one somehow. This is half a gallon of coolant that I just took out, like you saw. The reason I'm showing it looks good. Last time when I changed coolant, it got changed to a red color, and that's probably because there was a gallon or so of red coolant still in the truck. So to see that this is still gold after a few thousand miles, that's a good sign. I filled this guy up, that's 5 gallons, plus we got one more here. So there's 6 gallons if I need it, and I'm hoping that I don't need it. So the trip to AutoZone's about 3 or 4 miles, and I'll probably do a little parking lot swap out, and we'll go from there. Well, we made it here at AutoZone, and our coolant temp looks fine, so I guess it's holding. I have a theory about why it blew off, so let me first shut her down, eat my lunch, haven't eaten all day, and I will catch up with you when we got a new part. All right, here's our new part, and I have this piece out because this is how I'm going to explain what I think happened. So you got these two tabs, and they fit on this lip right here. And my theory was that the one I have on there right now, these were kind of squished inwards a little bit, and as a result, it was no longer holding on that lip. So it was able to kind of get knocked off and start leaking. So my hope is this one fits a little more snug, and we'll be good to go from there. I think this piece was the problem. There's an O-ring in here. Everything seems solid in there. There's no, seems good quality, you know. Materials are good quality. The O-ring is definitely not going anywhere. You can feel it in there, and a fresh O-ring should last a while. So I'm thinking this was the cause. So I'm gonna go ahead and put this back together and swap it. Tighter grip from the side like this. Just like
So. Oh, yeah. That is, got some pressure there. Fortunately, it's not too hot. And then rotate sideways.
Did get coolant all over my hands.
And then use the needle nosers. There's two tabs on the bottom. Tighten them down. Wow, so this thing didn't really want to come off that easy. Nothing really seems to be wrong with it. And then if I take this piece here, slide it in, it seems like it should be fine. I don't know. Anyways, let's grab our new one. This time, going to install it straight down like that. That feels good to me. And in case I have to remove this again. There you go. That should work.
Well, here we are after a 10-mile test drive, looking pretty dry there with the new one on. I mean, it fit on there pretty nice. Like, it felt like it was a good fit when I put it on. It does look very similar to the old one as far as how the tabs are positioned. Like, they don't protrude at all from there. They just kind of sit there. They are on that lip, though, easily. You know, they're definitely on there. So I'm thinking that we'll just see how this one does. Maybe this other one here was just a bad one. I don't know. But I'm going to keep this guy as a spare. Anyways, backup plans. Could run a 90-degree 5/8 line with a barbed adapter or something in between that hose and the little elbow. That might work. Could explore some sort of brass or metal fitting that would actually fit over this 5/8. That's one option. It's an idea. And then the final option is try to figure out what the OEM Cummins part number is and see if I can get an OEM one that has the yellow tabs on it. That could be my best hope. But we'll see. We'll see how this guy does here. If this blows off, then I know we gotta make a design change here. So that's gonna be it for the day. At least I have this tentatively fixed. We'll just see how it does over the next maybe 1,000 miles or so. If it's still holding on after 1,000 miles, I'm start getting some confidence back that that's gonna be okay. But I think I'm permanently, as long as this thing's on there, I'm permanently gonna be carrying 5 gallons of water with me just in case we have a repeat of what happened today. Also, while I was at the alignment shop, they took a measurement on my tires and told me that 3 of my 4 tires are at 11/32nds and one of them is at 12/32nds. And this, doing the math, would tell me that these tires will have a lifespan of about 45,000 miles, which is actually pretty bad. I've had much better success on my 5.9 with getting 70, 80, 100,000 miles out of a set of tires. 45K would be a big disappointment. I'm hoping the new alignment and whatnot will help get a little bit more lifespan if they wear slower going forward. But we'll have to see about it. The tires really don't look that bad. They have 15,000 miles on them. I recently did a video about that. They really don't look that bad at all. So we'll see how it goes. only way to tell is to find out. So that's the update on the tire. All right, so here's another random segment for the video. Windshield wipers. What windshield wipers do I like? I have the same windshield wipers on both trucks. These are Trico Neoforms. They're beam style wipers. They whip that rain right off your windshield. And they're great for interstate driving because they're pretty aerodynamic. So just the aerodynamics of them and not having turbulence from a non-beam style windshield wiper actually helps that rain roll off your windshield at high speeds. But the wipers themselves are fairly quiet and they do whip that rain right off. The only downside to them is that they're so aerodynamic that when they get up to the top, especially on the driver's side, they get up to the top of their rotation right about here and they're pointed like this. And when they start whipping back down, it actually drags, it whips the rain right back in front of your face almost. You know, not really in the middle of your view, but off to the left side here, it whips that rain right back. But that's probably due to the aerodynamics. This truck has the same ones. I really like them a lot. This truck really needed it. For some reason, this is an aftermarket windshield. And for whatever reason, when it rains, water has a tendency to smear on this windshield. There's nothing I've been able to do about it. I've put Rain-X on here. I've scrubbed it down real good. I've even wiped it down with vinegar and whatnot. No success there. So having a good windshield wiper that can sweep that rain right off is important on this truck especially. Wish I could fix that windshield smearing problem though. How about soap? What do I use to wash my trucks? Well, this is what I have right now. I really like this. I've used it the last couple times. I'm gonna do a little wash now that I'm out here and thinking about it. It's a nice day. So I think I'll do a little wash. This stuff has been really good, and it does have that hydrophobic property where water will bead up on this stuff. So it creates little layers. It's a wash and wax. So is this. This is what I've used a lot in the past and can't go wrong here. Both of these have cleaned the truck really well. I've even got that cheap blue stuff at Walmart that does a good job cleaning the truck as well. I mean, I don't think it has that waxiness in it, the cheap stuff, but it did a very good job just to get all the dirt and road grime off the trucks. So that is, that's where I'm gonna end it. I'm gonna end it with a time lapse. I'm going to hose the trucks down, get them clean, and I will probably catch up with y'all after Christmas. So have a Merry Christmas, everyone. And I'll catch up with you hopefully before New Year's.